Alright guys, before the video begins, I just want to say if you didn't know, this is a brand new channel, so the chances are you're not subscribed, so make sure to click that subscribe button, and in the words of my grandpa,
screw it, bitch!
Cock-a-doodle-doo.
Y'all, we back with a video testing the wish ball number 2, and this time we got the official Molten FIBA GG7X, a highly requested ball that we get from Wish. It looks official. It's the newer version of the last Wish ball that we got. Already, I can already tell it's a little bit better. The materials is really good. It's sticky and it bounces. Hopefully it doesn't lose air as fast as the last one. And if you're wondering why I'm wearing the hoodie, it's a shout out to Carmelo. You know, he's about to get cut by the Rockets, so you know, I had to shout Carmelo out. Carmelo's best years were on the USA basketball team, where they used the Molten FIBA ball in the Olympics. And yeah, let's get into the test.
I got it. Where's this dude? I guess it's my turn.
Get out of here. Give me the keys. Give me the keys. What's up, everybody? If you remember, over the summer, I actually tested out the $17 older style Molten FIBA ball from Wish. As you can see, the ball is a little darker. The yellow part right here is a little gold. It deflates without even touching the basketball. And it got dirty hella fast. As you can see, it's pretty goddamn dirty. So go watch this video if you haven't already. But anyways, as I said, this was a highly requested video. The updated Molten GG7X ball from Wish, that's actually FIBA approved. Not to be confused with the official ball that they use in the Olympics and in FIBA, the BGLX. That's made out of real leather, while this is composite leather. As you can see, it's the new one. It says the date 2015-2019. As always, before we get into the review, remember to subscribe to the channel, press the bell next to it so you get a notification every time I drop a new video, and follow me on Instagram. And like that, let's get into the video. As always, we start off with the looks and the initial thoughts of the product, and in this case we got the GG7X Molten FIBA basketball. Right off the bat, it looks a lot more official than the first Wish ball that I tested out. I actually thought I ordered the indoor ball last time when I got this one, but it turned out to be the outdoor ball. This is the indoor ball. It came in the wish package, how the last wish ball came flat and deflated with just bubble wrap covering it. It came with this tag as well, if you can read Chinese. And they gave me this little dime bag. It came with this, which kind of looks like cheese, but it's actually the net for a basketball hoop, as well as a needle to pump the basketball with. But I'm pretty sure you need a hoop and a rim for the net to work, as well as a pump for the needle to work. So it's kind of useless by itself. I don't know why Wish sent me those, but thanks Wish for the free stuff. As you can see, the colors and the paint is right. It's orange, and the yellow part actually being like a yellow beige color. As you can see, the paint is starting to chip off slightly after playing with it a few times, but you know, that's not a big deal to me. The ball does have a strong odor of spray paint, so maybe that's why the paint is chipping off, because it's spray painted on. Everything on this ball, according to the pictures on the official Molten website on the GG7X ball, looks on point to me. There's no bumps and defects on it. As you can see, it's pretty smooth. All the lettering is centered, unlike the last ball, which you could see words and letters and logos off-centered and kind of slanted. Now, I don't have the official $100 GG7X from the Molten website to compare the words and lettering to see if the placements are correct, but I'm pretty sure it is, because that's pretty easy to duplicate. Of course, you got the little Tinder logo on the O here and right here. Shout out to everybody who's found love on Tinder. The looks and the initial thoughts grade is a 9.3 out of 10. Honestly, I was blown away by the looks of it, and it would have been a perfect 10 if the paint didn't start to already chip. Moving on to the grip of the, ball. So on the last ball, the ball had a rough grip for outdoor surfaces. However, after playing with it just a few times outdoors, the grip starts to lose its, loses its grip. However, the Wish ball number 2 has the smooth leather and feel of an indoor ball. I will say that the grip is not as good as a Wilson Evolution, but it's on par as like a Spalding TF1000. Honestly, the grip is solid on this ball. You know, sometimes it's good to have a solid, firm grip of some balls, you know? So while the grip is solid, it's also really smooth when you shoot it. It doesn't rough up your fingers like the $5 Walmart ball or the first ball from Wish. The grip grade, 7.4 out of 10. Moving on to the feel. Like I said in the first basketball video I did from Wish, feel is the most important part of a ball. Every time you see the balls, man, you just gotta grab it, you know? You just gotta feel it, you know? Hey man, not saying that the ball is the most important thing to your game, but sometimes if the feel's not right, the shots don't go in as much and your handle's not as good as it used to be. But then again, if your handles and shot is good, it shouldn't matter what ball you have, but the ball can enhance your game. For instance, if you can dribble an actual rock and make a basket with an actual rock, then your handles and shooting ability might be really good with the actual basketball. So for the official FIBA balls, the BGLX, it takes a while to break in because those are real leather, while this, the GG7X, albeit one from Wish, is composite leather. And because it's composite leather, you don't have to break it in. It's good off the jump. The feel is smooth, like I said, in the grip department. And the only thing wrong with this ball, and it has to do with the feel, it's heavy as people will say, well, Evan, take the air out of the ball. That has nothing to do with the materials of the ball, and the materials are pretty heavy. Ask my guys Tony and Neil, who helped me make this video. The first thing they said when they touched this ball, they're like, that's heavy. And I'm not exaggerating, that's how they really talk. And when they first shot it, the ball would clank hard off the rim. Not for me though, because, you know, I'd be swishing it. To show you how heavy it is, I'ma just drop it. Yeah. And I filled the ball with a decent amount of air, but the ball doesn't bounce as high as other balls normally would. You really gotta pound it when you're dribbling this ball, which in turn improves your handles. Feel grade, 7.2 out of 10. Moving on to the durability of the ball, we keep comparing this ball with the first ball we got from Wish, which is only right because this ball sucked. This ball would lose air when you're dribbling, shooting, and it would lose air when you're not doing anything. So I wanted to test this out. After playing pickup with this ball, shooting with this ball, doing dribbling drills with this ball, overnight I left it in my car to see if it would deflate like the other ball did, and what do you know, it didn't. So A plus to Wish for having this ball not deflate while I sleep. That's all you can ask for in a basketball. However, like I said earlier, the paint on this ball is already starting to chip, so be cautious of that as well. Durability grade, 7 out of 10. Moving on to the price. The price is $20 compared to the real one on the Molten site, which is $100. Now, this is the GG7X, or on the website, the BGGX. But on the ball, it also says BGG7X. So if you're a Molten ball aficionado, someone explain to me all this BGG7XXX Tentacion lettering combination meanings. And this ball isn't to be confused with the $140 BGLX ball, which is the official ball that FIBA uses for the Olympics. This is just FIBA approved. Price grade, is a 10 out of 10. Overall, for $20, man, I was skeptical. The pictures didn't look too good. It looked a little stock photo-ish, but man, this ball blew me away as it's comparable to a lot of the pricier balls on the market. Pricier ball. Overall rating, 8.2. out of 10. So I'm reading on the Molten site on the page of the GG7X ball. It says on the page it has the California Proposition 65 warning saying it has chemicals that can cause cancer. So yeah, it's a good ball, but you know, if it's gonna cause something serious like cancer, I'd probably just like pass on the ball. I'm gonna go burn this and wash my hands and take a shower. Anyways, thanks again for watching the video. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. What do you think of the Molten FIBA GG7X ball from Wish? Remember to watch my other videos next to me in the playlist up there and down there. Until next time, we out. Adios. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe.